What up, guys? Welcome back. Core File Notice Media again. I'm bringing you another science video, man. I got a couple messages on Facebook and some text messages saying that they really like the whole Mars thing that's over there with the homes and how you might be living in a couple hundred years and stuff like that. So I figured out, hey, man, I like this stuff too. So if you like it, I'll give you what you like. And if don't just send me a Facebook message or don't just comment on my Facebook channel. Comment and like right down here, because it boosts the algorithms. It puts me higher if someone puts in one of those keywords that are associated with this video. So like it here and comment down here, and we can have a convo down there. This is what it's all about, baby. That's what we're doing here. So this is an exciting article. So it came out a few days ago, and I really, really like it. It's very eye-opening. A lot of people are like, oh, black holes. Ooh, we don't know. We've never seen them before. Well, sit down and get learned, because you're going to get learned about some black holes.
Ready?
The title of this article is going to be Four Things We've Learned from the First Close-Up Images of a Black Hole. This comes from sciencenews.org. Link in the description below. And it is written by the one, the only, Lisa Grossman. You're very popular to me, Lisa Grossman. Keep up the good work. With that said, intros are done. Let's jump into it.
No! No! Cooper!
Three.
Cooper, what are you doing?
Newton's third law.
We're about to see the first close-up of a black hole. The Event Horizon Telescope, a network of 8 radio observatories spanning the globe, has set its sights on a pair of behemoths. Sagittarius A, the supermassive black hole at the center of the Milky Way galaxy, and an even more massive black hole 53.5 million light years away in galaxy M87. That is M87, the galaxy, not the made-up weapon in Call of Duty. Don't get those mixed up. In April 2017, the observatories teamed up to observe the black hole's event horizons, the boundary beyond which gravity is so extreme that even light can't escape it. After almost 2 years of rendering the data, scientists are gearing up to release the very first images in April, which is right now. Get excited. Here's what the scientists hope these images can tell us. What does a black hole really look like? Black holes live up to their names. The great gravitational beast emits no light in any part of the electromagnetic spectrum, so much themselves they don't look like much. But astronomers know the objects are there because of the black hole's entourage. As a black hole's gravity pulls in gas and dust and matter settles into an orbiting disk, with atoms jolting one another at extreme speeds, all that activity heats the matter white hot, so it emits X-rays and other high energy radiation. The most ferociously feeding black holes in the universe have disks that outshine all the stars in their galaxies. The EHT's image of the Milky Way's Sagittarius A is expected to capture the black hole's shadow on its accompanying disk of bright material. Computer simulations and the laws of gravitational physics give astronomers a pretty good idea what to expect. Because the intense gravity near the black hole, the disk light will be warped around the event horizon in a ring, so even the material behind the black hole, it will be visible. And the image will probably look asymmetrical. Gravity will bend light from the interior part of the disk towards Earth more strongly than the outer part, making one side appear brighter in a lopsided ring. Does general relativity hold up close to a black hole, you might be asking yourself, because I wonder that same thing. The exact shape of the ring may help break down one of the most frustrating stalemates in theoretical physics. The twin pillars of physics are Einstein's theory of general relativity, which governs massive and gravitational rich things like black holes, and quantum mechanics, which governs a weird world of subatomic particles. Each works precisely in its own domain, but they can't work together. General relativity as it is and quantum mechanics as it is are incompatible with each other, says physics Leah Mendora, sa-ba-ba, of the University of Arizona in Tucson. Shout out to the U of A in Tucson. I used to live down there. The U of A is really, really awesome. Great place to live. If you're from Tucson, holla at your boy, Wildcats. Arr. Or meow, I guess. I don't know. Arr. I'm a bulldog, so I just bark at everything. Okay, so... So sorry for all that rhyme, but after that, she says, rock or a hard place, something has to give. If general relativity buckles out of black hole's boundaries, it may point the way forward for theoretics. Ugh, really, really cool. Since black holes are the most extreme gravitational environments in the universe that we know of, they're the best environment to crash test theories of gravity, like throwing theories at the wall and seeing whether or how they break. In general, relativity does hold up. Scientists expect that the black hole will have a particular shadow and thus ring shape. If Einstein's theory of gravity breaks down, a different shadow. The doctor and her colleagues at the University of Arizona ran computer simulations of 12,000 different black hole shadows that could differ from Einstein's predictions. If it's anything different, alternative theories of gravity, just got Christmas presents, says Mendoza, who presented the simulation results in January in Seattle at the American Astronomical Society meeting. Even slight deviations from general relativity could create different enough shadows for EHT to probe, allowing astronomers to quantify how different what they see is from what they expect. Do stellar corpses called pulsars surround the Milky Way's black hole? It's another good question. For those who don't know, Google. Another way to test general relativity around black holes is watch how stars careen around them. As light flees the extreme gravity of a black hole's vicinity, its waves get stretched out, making the light appear rendered. This process, called gravitational redshift, is predicted by general relativity and was observed near Sagittarius A last year. So far, so good for Einstein. Einstein knows what he's doing, baby. Come on now, you can't doubt Einstein. No, I'm totally kidding. The whole purpose of science is proving what theories are and using the scientific method, and this is really, really cool. An even better way to do the same test would be with a pulsar, a rapidly spinning stellar corpse that sweeps the sky with a beam of radiation and a regular cadence that makes it appear to pulse. Gravitational redshift would mess up the pulsar's metronic pacing, potentially giving a far precise test of general relativity. The dream for most people who are trying to do a Sagittarius science in general is to try to find a pulsar or pulsars orbiting the black hole, says astronomer Scott Ransom of the National Radio Astronomy Observation in Charlottesville, Virginia. There are a lot of quite interesting and quite deep tests of general relativity that pulsars can provide that EHT alone won't. Despite careful research, no pulsars have been found near enough to Sagittarius A yet, partly because gas and dust in the galactic center scatters their beams and makes them very, very difficult to spot, but EHT is taking the best look yet at the center of the radio wavelength, so Ransom and his colleagues hope it might be able to spot some. It's a fishing expedition in general, and the chances of catching a whopper are really, really small, Ransom says, but if we do, it's totally worth it.
Okay. I know zoomed out. Approaching the event horizon.
There we go. That's most of the article. I'm not going to go ahead and keep reading it for you because I don't want to make these too long. But if you are very, very interested and want to read it yourself and are annoyed as hell at my voice, as always, link in the description below. There's a whole nother segment on here called Do Some Black Holes Make Jets? And they have a multi-paragraph explaining if they do or if they don't. But I hope you like this. I find this stuff super interesting. You know, we're getting the very first images. I've been throwing things up in the background, so if you were just listening to me, you might want to go back and see all these images that I put up here because it is really, really cool stuff. Hopefully in the next couple of decades, hopefully we can, you know, start hurling things at this and running really, really good tests and see how this works. What are the black holes going to do? Can we go into it like an Event Horizon?
To bend space time. Look, it'll take the Lewis and Clark 1,000 years to reach our nearest star. But the Event Horizon could be there in a day.
If it worked.
You can come down, it's perfectly safe.
Can we fly into a black hole like in Sphere and get teleported to other parts of the galaxies and find amazing things like the Sphere that give us the ability to manifest anything that we dream?
Time travel. And when we get back, we're gonna tell everyone how it's possible, how it's done, what the dangers are. But then why 50 years in the future, when this spacecraft encounters a black hole, does the computer call it an unknown entry event? Why don't they know? If they don't know, it means we never told anyone. And if we never told anyone, it means we never made it back. Hence, we die down here. Just as a matter of deductive logic, Norm.
That is the real question that science needs to be asking itself. Once again, this is Corey from File Notice Media. If you made it this far, I love you for it. Like, share, subscribe, shill myself, go, go, go. Tell your friends, we're out of here. Have yourself a great day.